Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, guys, wherever you are in this beautiful world, whenever you're watching this YouTube video, welcome to the Bitcoin Family YouTube channel. For the newcomers, my name is Didi. I hodl some bitcoins and living in Mexico at the moment. Taking a short look in a TA video today to see what is happening to Bitcoin. Let's quickly jump into the charts. Bam! This is the day channel. Every candle is a day. Like you can see on the day chart, we have been saying, me and my other personality or something like that. Yes, I have a split personality. You can see that we have this bullish divergence. You know, the price is going down and the RSI is coming up, and you can see that we are finding support on that red line, the 200 day moving average, which means this is very positive, and it is probably the moment we jump up in price. We break this green level over there, and then we go to hunt for that 53k over there. I believe that that is going to happen. Now here on the weekly, you can see the same. We are finding support on the 50 weekly moving average, that red thick line. We are down below the logarithmic growth curve, the midline, that we have been fighting over here. We broke it, we came down, so we will be fighting that again, but now it will be higher at 62k. The RSI also slowly moving up, and if you look in the past, every time when the RSI is moving up and we are above that red line, that is when the bullish momentum is there. So we need to stay above the red line, the RSI needs to turn up a little bit more in the weekly, and that would be the bullish momentum. And the only thing that is bothering me is the Gaussian channel. This is a 5-day chart. Every candle is 5 days. Every time when we get into this channel, we get sucked down to that midline, and I don't like that. And even sometimes to the bottom, if we look back further over here, look, when we got in, sucked to the midline, and from the midline, not having support, sucked even to the bottom, through the bottom over there, here in this area, March 2020. I don't think this is positive. This time that we came in here in June, that made it that we got sucked to the midline over there, and it took us almost all the way here, there, to October to get out. So that's from June to October. That's a lot of months fighting that resistance again. So I don't think it's positive that we are in there, but we touched the midline. We are now, this candle is going to close in, I think, 9 hours and 23 minutes, and that should be closing a little bit higher, in my opinion, than the candle before, to have a reversal. If not, the next candle can again go back to the midline at $43,200. Now, for the traders out there, yes, you can trade using our Bam Bam indicator. The Bam Bam indicator just tells you when to buy and when to sell, spot or leverage, you choose, for our chart. At the moment, the last trade you could have done was this one over here, the long. We had a candle closing above the yellow stepping line. We had the Bam Bam crossing over there. We had a green dot. And let's zoom in a little bit here. And we have a lot of green area. There was still a little bit bluish, which could be doubtful. But the moment it's completely green from here, and it could again be the same long. If you would have taken the long, let's say too late over there at the top a little bit, then you would now be in a profit of around 2.7% without leverage. If there will be a short flag, that will be the moment to exit, or when the candle closes down below the yellow stepping line, depending on your strategy, but you would be making profits. Now, let's quickly jump into some more really cool charts over here. Bam. Yeah, that's the one. This is the all-time highs of Bitcoin. 2013-14, we had 52 new all-time highs. In 2017, we had 74 new all-time highs after the halving. Now we only had 33 new all-time highs. So this is not enough all-time highs if you compare it to this one and that one. So in my opinion, there will be a shitload more of all-time highs to create that blow off top above 100k. I still believe this. Next chart. Bam, over here. And this is about mining, because people always ask me, who's mining, who's the miners? The most miners out there use pools, so they combine their mining hashing power in pools. The biggest pool out there is now, for example, Antpool. You have F2 pool. These are all pools that you can join to mine bitcoins. So there's a lot of pools. can see. Even OKX has a pool, KuCoin has a pool. These are pools. This is decentralized minings. But if you look where are these pools mining and how is Bitcoin being mined, then look at this. This is very cool because here you can see that it's not just people at home mining with their own build miners or the end miners or whatever. It's also huge public companies. The hash rate market share breakdown of public mining companies. They are public registered companies in stock markets. So for example, Bitfarms or HUT or Hive. These are all public companies mining Bitcoin. Do you really think that Bitcoin is there to go to zero when all these publicly listed mining companies are spending a shitload of money to mine Bitcoins? Have huge buildings, have huge monthly costs, have employees. Do you really think this is an industry that can still collapse? I don't think so, guys. That is what my opinion is. Now, that was everything for today. I hope you really enjoyed the short update. If you did do enjoy it, give the video a thumbs up, share with your friends and family, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell, and leave a message or a comment because I love to respond and read your comments, guys. And always remember to zoom out in Bitcoin and try to zoom in life. Don't freak about every minute chart in the every change in the minute chart, but freak about every minute in a day. Try to enjoy it completely. Always think about Bob Marley. Don't worry, be happy. Everything is gonna be all right. Thanks for watching. I see you tomorrow again. Bam.